The action about to begin. The umpires this afternoon, Peter Carey and John Russo, and away we go. And immediately a free kick. Mansfield to take it alongside the centre circle for the Bulldogs, putting it down towards half court. Good strong mark in defence by Brennan. About some selections. Bernie, who do you like?
Yes, I think Footscray can break their duck here today, Dennis.
Good afternoon, Pete.
Good afternoon,
like?
Dan. Winning form, good form. I'll go for the Bulldogs too.
Coleman almost. Here's Atkins. Smith. Coleman in trouble. Gets away. Nicely done. Down towards half forward. Del Rey in front. Fisted away. Worsfold's got it. Hepburn across half back. Very high kick. Down towards half forward. McPherson going back with courage. Hitting superb mark. No, he's spilled it as he hit the ground. In fact, it's been paid.
Yeah, that was magnificent, wasn't it? Brett Heady.
And 50 metres. What a mark.
That was a magnificent mark, Brett Heady. They've really missed him in this Eagles side on that across that half forward line. Look at that. That is magnificent. Kept his eye on the ball. I think Bernard too, he's got the job of picking up Brett Heady today.
Well, what was the 50 metre for, Bernie?
Good question. I couldn't pick it out at all, Pete, so I'm not too sure on that one.
Well, Tui was remonstrating with the umpire, indicating he thought the Eagles had played on.
To be quite honest, I thought they had too.
Yeah, it happened very quickly, didn't it?
I didn't think the mark had been paid, and I guess that's why they did play on.
Well, here's Heady. He'll kick from just inside the 50. A fairy tale return. The Eagles a goal. Footscray yet to score.
That's one area where the Eagles have been falling down on their forward line this year, of course, with Sumich with those injury and suspension problems. That's that mark again, a great mark from Heady, and aided by that 50 metre penalty, brought him to within 40 metres. Very good kick for goal, but they have been falling down badly on their forward line, not kicking many points. Their averages are fourth worst in the league.
So back into the centre, a controversial start at Subiaco with a 50 metre penalty against Footscray. Wine to Atkins. The Bulldogs will be expecting a lot from him today. Mansfield's kick is short and marked by Grant. Still inside the centre square though, so a long way from home, and they're going the long way home, but Wallace is playing on the wing today. At least that's where he started. Hawkins, who today breaks Arthur Oliver's games record, become the second highest number of games played at Footscray, behind Teddy Whitten. Kemp, that's 272. No one home on the outer wing. Wallace gets there just at the same time as does Turley. Boundary throw-in. Atkins actually does the ruck work down to Tui. Tui, a short kick up to Grant, got two hands to it. Mark not paid, correct decision. Liberatore tackled well, the ball spills free. And a free kick going to the West Coast Eagles, or is it going to be a bounce from John Russo?
It has to be a kick to the Eagles. Liberatore threw it out in the end from that very good tackle.
Well, Liber, of course, one of the best tacklers in the game. On the end of it there himself, Jakovic's kick. Down towards full forward, Mark's good, chance for Turley. Ugel, always dangerous near goals, looks for a hand pass. Dwayne Lamb, oh, fumbles at the crucial moment. Liberatore applies the tackle, the ball spills free. Maloney overruns it. McIntosh, that knee heavily bandaged. Baxter kicks from a standing start and gets Footscray out of danger only momentarily.
Close to the boundary on the outer side. Worsfold working hard. Did well in a confined space. Jakovic, probing kick. McIntosh from behind it, falls forward. Langdon on his left side. And the mark is held by Campbell. Campbell plays on. This is Wind. Foster towards the wing. Coleman lively early towards his position, centre half forward. Kemp is favoured by the kick, uncontested. Dean Kemp across the ground. Chris Lewis inside. Chansey, McKenna. This is Hepburn forward of the centre circle. Bad kick. Langdon aided by the umpire. He got a shepherd from the umpire as he kicked the goal. Now he's missed. Minor score. Peter Foster making the point to the central umpire, get out of the road.
I think he got in Langdon's way initially there, Dennis, when Langdon was attempting to take that mark, and then Foster fell foul of him also.
It was a good pick. 1-1 to no score. Campbell towards the outer side. Wine in from the side. Foster so strong overhead. Peter Foster from half back. through centre. Coleman the target, controls it brilliantly.
It's Hepburn picking up Coleman at centre-half back, and Jakovic doing the ruck work.
On to Smith, not the greatest of hand passes, but Smith rather expeditious out of the centre circle, tried to find Ballantyne, a late inclusion in the side, couldn't do so. The Eagles' defence working well, running in twos and threes already. This is Jakovic, who's had a great season. Gets around Smith, long kick, heady again, this time Tui right there with him, good defence. Or fine bump by Wallace, Tui, McPherson. And Tui should be able to pick it up in front of Mainwaring. Lewis cuts in front of him, too high. Free kick and the advantage, Liberatore from right centre wing. Footscray into attack up towards half forward. But it's McKenna onto Brennan. And this defence, as I said a moment ago, working well today. Of course, with Guy McKenna back there, it does take that more solid outlook. That's a free kick to Footscray. Foster will take it at half back. McPherson, one of the Bulldogs stalwarts, up to midfield. Looks for Coleman, almost a mark. Kemp, almost a throw. Finally gets rid of it. Matera. One bounce. Will he have another one? No. Low trajectory pass, oh. And McIntosh. Bobby Simpson would have been happy with that. Matera had moved well down and takes the mark in front of McPherson.
And that'll be 50 metres, I think, against Steve McPherson.
Well, you can understand that one. I am still puzzled about the first one.
Yes. Straight back to the goal line against Steve McPherson to make sure of this goal.
If that's 50 metres, that's got to be a report, doesn't it?
Well, you'd think so.
I don't want to be look at me like that. But
it's a fair question. But the umpires, Dennis, in recent weeks have been cracking down on players, putting knees in, etc. Matera goals.
He's got to go back and have that kick again, I think. The umpire just not happy. Time on still.
But it does beg the question, Dennis.
It does, Dennis, yes.
Okay. I just wanted to clear that up.
It does, yes.
But umpires, Dennis, just going back on that point, they have been looking at this, haven't they, in the last few weeks?
Yeah, arriving late's one thing.
That's right. He's got the goal.
At BP, we like to think our new service stations are the best in the world, which is why our special fact-finding team is constantly checking, as unobtrusively as possible, how well our stations are maintaining the standard. Thank you. We're pleased to say the results have been very encouraging. But why not come and check us out for yourselves? BP, on the move.
Has Turley. Some interesting matchups.
The other interesting one, Dennis, is McPherson and Lewis.
They're jostling across the Eagles' half forward line as we speak. Meantime, Mansfield out of the middle. Wallace and Mainwaring on each other. Wallace leads in the race. Nice slide. Tries to get it back to Liberatore. Good desperation by McKenna, though. Lamb, quick hands away. Jakovic to McKenna. This is Mainwaring around Coleman. Testing time for the Bulldogs. This at the present time. Turley. Well, we've seen this before in recent seasons. The Bulldogs, of course, arrived in town on top of the table, and their mettle is about to be tested now. If they can weather this, get back into the game.
They arrived late last night too, Dennis. A different ploy being taken by the coach.
Yep. Turley kicks. It's another goal.
There's Footscray arriving in Perth last night at 9 o'clock. It has been done before. I know Hawthorne fancy that also coming in on the Saturday night late so that the players straight to bed and they're not just standing around, waiting around for something to happen. They're straight to bed and get up in the morning and come to Subiaco Oval. But, the play at the moment, they're doing very well across that half-back line with McKenna doing particularly well and running the ball down to that forward line.
So back into the centre, a dream start by the West Coast Eagles, who take on a different complexion at this ground. Wine wins it to Coleman. Atkins, ball socketed away by Jakovic. Out of the pack and out of trouble and out of bounds. So boundary throw in left half forward flank as Malthouse would be delighted with the Eagles' start so far. Couldn't have wished for better against the top dogs. Footscray first, the Eagles 10th. When they played last year, the positions were exactly the reverse. Heady, who took mark of the day. Liberatore to Mansfield, busy early. Low trajectory kick up towards midfield, and Djakovic already starting, takes the mark. Stray breaking down across the half forward line. If it was a cold day, their forwards would be freezing at the other end. Foster and McIntosh. Pretty handsome sort of a bandage, that, isn't it? From a standing start, Worsfold. Great kick. Close. One behind. Now John Worsfold registering his first score of the day. One behind, and the Eagles lead by 20 points. Footscray scoreless and haven't looked like scoring.
Tony Campbell in the bright sunshine. The breeze not a factor. Driving it to the outer side. From behind Hepburn, knocking it away. Lewis close to the boundary line. Main Waring. Wine couldn't control it. And he's back surely. No free kick. The umpire wants to ball it up. Just inside the attacking 50. Well, coming into this round, Footscray were the best first quarter team in the AFL, averaging 33 points through their opening six games. Yet to get one in this game so far. Brennan's limping off the ground. Laidley's coming on.
That's a bad loss too, Dennis. Brennan very solid in defence for the West Coast Eagles.
We'll check the matchups and how they redeploy the troops down there in a moment. Meantime, Lamb slung. Atkins couldn't control it. Eddie sliding through. Lewis almost. Foster, now Langdon. McIntosh, 15 metres out directly in front. He's been lively on the forward line so far.
Yes, he has been good, McIntosh. He was named on the halfback flank in the first game for 92 for the Eagles. He did play in the Foster's Cup game against Geelong, where he injured that knee initially. But Tony Campbell deciding there to stay off McIntosh, giving him about 6 or 7 metres.
He played 17 games last season, just 19 years of age. I think he's got it, he has.
Throughout our history, Australians have realised the secret to survival is in looking after our own. And for 175 years, we have too.
Goal kickers for the West Coast, Hedy, Turley, Matera, and now Ashley McIntosh, his first goal for the year. First game for the year, member of the grand final side that went down to Hawthorn in 1991. Langdon went through solidly. The kick was from Lamb, albeit a short one. Lou Vittori's attempted smother not successful. Foster from halfback. Del Rey. Grant tried to burst through the pack, not really successful. Lewis's hand pass was partially blocked. McKenna, what towering torpedo punt kick down towards half forward. Ugel the mark.
Well, that's where they're really killing Footscray, across that half back line and kicking it long like that. McKenna, magnificent play.
Heady. And the ball through off the hands of the pack for one rushed behind.
There's a fight too across the half forward line for Footscray. It started with Laidley and Del Rey. Laidley's gone on to Del Rey, replacing Brennan.
I think they're just trying to get warm down there, Dennis. Not much action at that end of the ground so far. 4-3 to nothing. Coleman, Smith. Smith from left half back. Del Rey the target. Couldn't take the mark. Socket off the ground out towards the centre wing position. Collignoc back to Grant. Centering kick from him. Eagles aplenty, and they're doing it well. White's kick. Wine. Liberatore. Over to Steve Wallace, one of the veterans in the Footscray side. This is about as far forward as Footscray's come so far. White to Waterman, and they're away and running again. Hepburn. Dwayne Lamb at left centre wing. Long probing kick. Toohey takes the safe mark over Brett Heady. The exact same spot where Heady took that screamer only in the first 30 seconds of the match. Footscray away again through Steve Wallace on right centre wing. Coleman in front. One-handed. Atkins almost a throw. Picked up by Lamb. And the bounce is a fickle one. Hepburn should take it for the Eagles.
Is it left half forward? Centering kick. Ugel missed it. Recovers pretty well. Langdon. Liberatore trips surely. No free kick.
Strange.
Mansfield finds Coleman.
It could well be 50.
He made him earn it, Dennis, didn't he? Jakovic, who's changing with Hepburn in the centre-half back position.
There was no 50 as Wallace boots it down to Del Rey. The Eagles seeking out contact at the present time. Interesting. Just off the ball and around the ball. And really looking for collisions. Always a good sign of a team that wants to play footy. This is Lewis. Chips it out wide. Kemp. It's been missing in their football. Kemp at right half back. Towards centre wing. Lamb in front. Uncontested. Wanted to go. That was a mistake. That's holding the ball.
Yes. He was off. He didn't realise Foster was there, Dennis.
No.
Covering.
Pete was very quiet that time. From the wing down towards half forward. Hawkins in front. The Eagles have got the numbers. Close to the boundary line. Still he goes, Doug Hawkins. Brilliantly played. Sweeping hand pass to accommodate Coleman. Kicks inside the 50. Laidley will need to go. He fists away from Del Rey. It comes back to him. Gets it to Jakovic, the main Waring. Not a good kick. He wobbles it down towards half forward. The bounce favours the Eagles. Heady to Worsfold. About 10 metres in the clear. He can go back to Heady and does. He's just outside the 50. Vacant goal square. Heady may have got the goal. He has.
To develop the most advanced four-wheel drive in the world, we tested it in the most rugged country on Earth.
Heady has two goals and the Eagles on fire. The Bulldog bubble not burst yet, but it's not far away, one thinks. Lewis out of the centre. Foster tries to tie it up. Langdon ties him up and it will be a bounce at half forward. A couple of fiery customers.
And himself, I think he tied himself in a knot.
The India rubber man. 55 metres out from the Eagles' goal. That's a blitzkrieg at the moment. Footscray need to be in touch at quarter time. Lee Vittore applies a tackle, then pushes Worsfold out. No free kick. There is a free kick.
Matera to take it, Pete. Hold one, holding by Collignup.
Peter Matera too far out to score. McIntosh on the lead. Campbell out of bounds. Boundary throw in, about the same distance out from goal.
Those four players back into the side, very important, Dennis, for the Eagles, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
McKenna especially across half-back.
McKenna's been brilliant so far, hasn't he?
And Heady with those two goals.
Heady, yeah.
McKenna's like he's an attacking half-back, isn't he? He's probing kicks. Lamb into space, close to full forward. Out they come, the rush. Ugel, will he look for a hand pass? Tries the kick, bends it back. Oh, so close, one behind. Kick by Troy Ugel. Well, he had to make up his mind pretty quickly, Bernie, didn't he? He was thinking of the hand pass and then saw a space for the kick.
Yes, well, he could have probably kicked it in the end, but he kicked four goals last week for the Eagles.
Tony Campbell kicks in. Wind the target. Hepburn punches. Baxter. Pressure. Lane wearing. Long looping hand pass. McPherson will go for the boundary line. Didn't quite find it. Ugel in the road. Bends it back across his body. Foster has the sit. Langdon's there. Oh. McPherson. Chance for McIntosh again. Campbell paddles out to a pack of players. Worsfold and Langdon are there. And Footscray able to tie it up once more.
Wasn't that a tackle by Langdon?
Oh, they're desperate, aren't they, Dennis? Oh,
Temper's becoming frayed.
Well, they lose touch with the final six if they lose today, of course, here at Subiaco.
So a bounce only 15 metres out. McIntosh taps down. Ugel again with the opportunity. Turley just about threw it out to Heady. His kick is off target and registers only a minor score. So 5 goals, 5. The Eagles now, effectively 6 goals, 10 scoring shots to nil.
A brief lull. Campbell, acquired from Melbourne. Straight down the middle. Wine looking to knock it on. Did well. Here's Foster. Smith's got the run of it. Unkind bounce though.
Kolenuk was held. He'll get the free kick.
It looks like he's moved on to the wing, Kolenuk, playing on Matera.
The Dogs needing a goal. This is Baxter on the wing, down towards half forward. Atkins must get the free. Averaging 28 possessions a game. Number six in the AFL, Atkins. Baxter just inside the 50. Darren Baxter, side trailing by 35 points, goes in short. That's very short. Mark is held by Ballantyne on the lead. Ballantyne can kick it a long, long way, so distance won't be a problem. Is that right, coach?
He did kick eight last week against, I think it was Melbourne reserves last week. And he can kick the ball prodigious distances. Dennis, you're right.
Coaching from Superboot.
As I said that, let's see what he does.
It's bending back nicely, but he hasn't got the distance. Off hands.
Well,
in fact, it's a mark being paid down there to Hepburn. Well,
I can't believe he couldn't make the distance from there unless there is some sort of wind that he was kicking into, Dennis, because he'd normally make that distance on his ear.
The way it went off the boot, though, it sort of started left and straightened up. It didn't look like good contact, did it?
I mean, look at the flags over there, though, on the scoreboard, Dennis. They are definitely favouring the end to which the West Coast Eagles are kicking.
Yes, it's backed around a little bit, but it's not strong. Meantime, Waterman in trouble. Hawkins hard against him, and the ball is out of bounds and will be thrown in. Just over 7.5 minutes remaining till quarter time, and the West Coast Eagles, the only team to score in this game so far. Campbell straight to Lewis, though, or rather it was Coleman straight to Lewis. Back in midfield, Kolenuk surrenders about 25 metres. Langdon is outnumbered. Toohey did well. Goes for the boundary line, Bernard Toohey, and runs it across.
You'll get the free though, Dennis. Upfield against John Worsfold. Heavy work on Bernard Toohey after he'd kicked that ball.
Kemp wants to take the kick, but it's not his to take. Smith will get it.
Rowan Smith at left centre wing. One of the form players so far in 92 for Footscray. Need some more from him this afternoon. Dwayne Lamb robes the pack well. Kicks up towards space. Turley will look for the favourable bounce. Fisted well clear by Baxter. Back to Lamb, though. Lamb kicks it back up the half forward. Ugel, a blind turn, but he nearly turned into trouble. Foster, strong in defence at half-back. Probing kick out towards Steve Watts, who marks at right centre wing. Mainwaring stands the mark. Clock ticking down to quarter time. The Bulldogs badly needing a goal. Atkins. Yes, yeah, strong lead and mark by Ballantyne. Now, a similar position, except he's on the other side of the ground, Bernie.
Well, normally you could kick 60 metres without a problem, John Ballantyne. So
maybe they've measured this with an elastic ruler.
No, I can't work out what happened with that last kick of his.
We'll reserve our decision.
That's what you paid for.
That's a better kick distance-wise, but accuracy is still lacking. And he's put it through for only one behind. So there's some more work needed at the Western Oval, it would appear. Ballantyne registering one behind. Footscray's first score?
Yep, first score, yep.
I wasn't quite sure if I'd missed a behind there, but that's not the case. It's taken them a long time to get that. Who's broken their duck? Hepburn. Coleman making sure he's not going anywhere, but Footscray breaking down across that half-back line. Waters gives the hand pass away, and Turley as if he'd taken a mark.
Some interesting work there by Foster.
Lately, rather. So Mansfield.
Langdon looked like the punching bag there, Dennis, didn't he?
Amazing.
The Brownlow medalist, Liberatore, to Coleman. And there he is again. Little Liber, dragged out. And a tackle that he would have been proud of. Djakovic has been doing some heavy and some good work at half back. Waterman relays the pass onto Lewis. And again, the Eagles running the ball superbly out of defence. White kicks to half forward. Two Footscray players are there. Baxter, one of their Dower defenders, but he's kicked it straight to Worsfold, who marks it left half forward flank.
Turley, 30 metres from his opponent.
And away he goes. Not a well delivered kick. Wine into trouble. Golden opportunity off the ground. Langdon hits the post. So Carl Langdon kicking his second behind for the day. 5-6 to 1 point.
Four and a half minutes till quarter time. This is McPherson up from the back pocket. Goes in short. Smith just wide of the mark. Taken by Waters. Penny. Well, you make that error coming out, they punish you going back.
Yes, and that's an area that Footscray really has to work on, because on so many occasions the turnover has been costly. They haven't had the crummers around half forward, and every time the ball's hit the deck, it's been West Coast Eagles players running the ball out of defence.
What's the betting on this shot? Heady. This is his home ground. He played for Subiaco. Right outside the dugout, this one. Would have taken the shot at training, I would imagine, hundreds of times.
Kick two.
Brett Heady. Close to the man on the mark. He's kicked it. Local knowledge is...
We are the cash converters. We're the easy way to trade. We buy and sell all kinds of goods, and your money's easily made.
Your local cash converter needs stock fast. Wanted urgently. TVs, videos, radios, tools, power tools and machinery, musical instruments, sporting goods and jewellery. Top prices paid at cash converters today.
Yeah, when you buy, sell or trade, cash converters will make your day.
Cash converters.
Brett Heady is back in a blaze of glory. As the time remaining and the difference between these two sides, Hepburn, who's doing very well, wins it down. Waters ran into a dead end. Wallace is winning on his wing, but Mainwaring is getting possessions. They shared them there. Mainwaring, telling kick back into the forward line. Heady! Oh, almost applies the tackle. McPherson's got it. Towards the outer side, Wallace in front. Good mark. Very good mark. Needs to settle it down. Here's Wind, having a wonderful season, to McPherson. Up from half back towards the wing. Matera goes back. Good contest by Kolanuk. Taken by Jakovic, though. High up and under. Coleman, eyes only for the ball. Matera looking to fist away. Smith again to McPherson. Not a good kick. Atkins and Waters body to body off. Very clever mark.
Atkins at midfield. As the clock ticks down to quarter time, under 3 minutes left. Disaster for Footscray in the opening quarter. McKenna under White. What a difference McKenna has made already in the opening few, opening quarter of this match. Lamb to half forward. McIntosh, Ugel, counted into by Maloney. Crowd looking for a free kick. McIntosh off the ground into space at full forward. Follows it up well. Winder's there. He needs support. Lewis has got the speed. Lewis tried to get it back to McIntosh, who bends it across his body into the goal square. And the mark has been paid. Mansfield. Oh, Matera. Great mark.
And he's showing a lot of form today too. Matera doing very well on his wing. Could have been 50 there again.
I would have thought so.
The crowd was certainly looking for it.
All the time.
Craig Turley.
Well, Glenn Coleman got dragged last week for giving a 50-metre penalty when he knocked the ball out of Hogg's hands.
So it wasn't once but twice there too, wasn't it?
That's right. I thought he would have been very careful today.
McIntosh well outnumbered there, and the ball over the boundary line in front of Mansfield again for a boundary throw. And this crowd has certainly built up in the last 10 or 15 minutes. Although there's some space at the other end of the ground, it's pretty congested where we are now.
Left mum with the washing.
Exactly. Ugel gets taken high. No free kick. Liberatore runs out of room. Good block there by Heady, who's kicked three goals so far in the opening quarter. As the Eagles have cut Footscray a bit, 6-6 to one behind. They can only get better. Langdon in front. Taps down. Here he is, the man of the moment. Snapshot this time. Won't be a score. McIntosh!
Okay, great mark from McIntosh. Back into the side. First game for the year for McIntosh.
That's a marvellous
replay. Watch Tony Campbell. He's up and down before acceptances, but that is a great grab. A strong pair of hands shown there by McIntosh.
He was up before nominations.
Well, the thing about that, when a guy goes early, it throws the rest of the pack out, doesn't it? And McIntosh has shown great concentration there to stay with it.
McIntosh for his second, which he gets. He's So with only seconds before quarter time, it's a disaster for Footscray. 7-6 to one behind.
This is a huge margin for Footscray to make up. 47 points down coming up to the quarter time break. Look at that mark again, a magnificent mark. It was almost over his head too. He almost had to put the hands back and drag it in.
He looks pretty fit, Dennis, is he? What's the word from the rooms?
Well, he's played a couple of games in the lead up to this. He's played twice, I think, for his side, but still a way to go match fitness.
11 seconds left in the quarter. 13 scoring shots to one. And the Bulldogs with the job ahead of them. Atkins, Waters, Kemp. The Eagles of old this afternoon down towards full forward. They might get another one. Heady. There's the siren. Can he make it? Four goals for the quarter like Gary Ablett did yesterday at Geelong. He kicked one from the boundary closer in, so he should be able to get this.
Yes, this one from about 45 metres out directly in front. Brett Heady, what a quarter he has had.
I mean, you talk about Ablett, but this guy, he's not in that league yet, but he is exciting, isn't he? There's something that sets him apart, Brett Heady.
The team certainly looks a lot different with him back in the side.
And at the other end, McKenna.
McKenna as well. Mentioned. And McIntosh also with some impact with two goals in the first quarter.
So Heady for goal number four in the first quarter and the Eagles eighth. Looks good. Is good. Four goals to Brett Heady in the opening quarter. And the West Coast Eagles blitzkrieg has resulted in 8-6 to one
and
behind
in
the opening term. And we have a fight right on the bell.